East German troops swooped down on the border between Red Berlin and the Free City in the pre-dawn hours to close the 66 points where movement between the sectors has been relatively free. East Berliners who held coveted jobs in the West were told to stay home, and the elevated trains were halted.
In August 1961, East Germany, with Soviet support, began construction on what was to become one of the most iconic symbols of the Cold War, the Berlin Wall. While the practical purpose of this wall was to stop the flow of East German residents to the Western-controlled side of Berlin, as the years went on, the wall became a physical symbol of the Iron Curtain that divided the West from the Soviet bloc. West Berlin remained an island of freedom and the epicenter of the burgeoning relationship between West Germany and the United States.
Station built with the aid of American funds. For many, it's the first nourishing food in a long time.
All free men, wherever they may live, are citizens of Berlin. And therefore, as a free man, I take pride in the words, Ich bin ein Berliner.
As the Cold War dragged on, communist control of the Eastern Bloc weakened. Economic collapse, political upheaval, and the emphasis on human rights in the Helsinki process led to increasing socio-political pressures on both local communists and their Soviet backers. The improving personal relationship between Gorbachev and Reagan led to a process of political renewal, glasnost and perestroika, which set in motion the events of 1989.
General Secretary Gorbachev, if you seek peace, if you seek prosperity for the Soviet Union and Eastern Europe, if you seek liberalization, come here to this gate. Mr. Gorbachev, open this gate. Mr. Gorbachev, tear down this wall.
Change was in the air. Peaceful protesters had been gathering every Monday night for months, calling for democratic reforms. On November 4th, 1989, nearly 1 million demonstrators gathered in East Berlin. Few could have foreseen what was to happen a few days later.
Entschlossen, heute eine Regelung zu treffen, die es jedem Bürger der DDR möglich macht, über Grenzübergangspunkte der DDR auszugehen.
On the 9th of November, 1989, West Berlin TV and radio broke the news. East Germany would allow its citizens to travel to the West, effective immediately. When border guards finally let the East Berliners pass through the wall, the world celebrated as thousands peacefully passed through what was now a door to liberty. Chancellor Gerhard Schroeder later would say that the wall did not fall. It was pushed down from east to west. Following a tour of Europe and a journey across the Atlantic Ocean, this segment of the wall will be a featured exhibit at the U.S. Diplomacy Center. Its journey was made possible by the Atlantic Council and the German company VNG Gas. Painted by artist Michael Fisher Art, this segment features the signatures of statesmen, democracy activists, diplomats, and political leaders who fought to end the Cold War. What once stood as a symbol of division, isolation, and repression is now a testament to the strength of diplomacy and the courage and triumph of freedom-loving people. It reminds us of the values at the core of the transatlantic relationship and the bonds of friendship between Germany and the United States.